On day 24, we'll leave Comfort Suites in Sacramento and drive over to Marshall Gold Discovery State Historic Park and look there at the place where gold was discovered. And then we will drive down to San Francisco. We'll drive around the end of the bay because we don't want to pay the toll on the bridge. And when we get into the city, we'll go see Baker Beach, go over to Haight-Ashbury District and look around there some, see the Painted Ladies, and then spend the night at the Castle Inn. Even though San Francisco is west of Sacramento, we head east. We're heading over to look at a special place where gold was discovered in California and setting off the gold rush. We'll be driving back up into the Sierra Nevada Mountains that we drove in so long to look at the national parks at the beginning of our trip. The State Park at Marshall Gold Discovery is a historical park, and we're going to be looking in this area. It covers a rather large area. We'll be looking at Sutter's Mill Replica, then we'll go to the museum, Marshall's Cabin, and finally the Marshall's Monument. John Sutter wanted to build a sawmill here to make lumber to build a town, and he hired James Marshall to construct that sawmill, and this is what it would have looked like. The sawmill is now gone, so a replica of Sutter's house and a replica of the mill have been built so you can see what it would have looked like. The logs would have been rolled up the right side of this ramp into the sawmill, where they would be attached to the saw, and then they would be cut into pieces and they would come out the other side. This was all powered by the paddle wheel you see at the bottom as water ran through the sluice. As Marshall was digging the sluice to let the water flow out of the river and into the mill and back into the river, this is where he found the gold. Now let's look around the museum some. Gold can be found all over the country, but it's not concentrated enough. In the yellow area you see here, this is where the gold is today. And you can see the gold flakes in this quartz. This is plaster gold, which is found in sandbanks, just laying among the sand. Let's listen to him tell about the gold price.
Bitcoin. The price of gold right now is $1,650 an ounce. So
how big are they now?
This is 1 ounce, a half an ounce, and a quarter of an ounce.
Okay, and they were what? How much value?
20, 10, and 5.
Okay, and they have how much?
Today, the big one is, the 1 ounce is $1,650. This one's half of that, and that's a quarter of that.
And you said nickel in it? On January 24th, 1848, James Marshall found sparkle in the tail race, and it was gold. On December 10th, 1848, James Poe gave a State of the Union. The accounts of the abundance of gold in that territory are of such an extraordinary character as could scarcely command belief were we not collaborated by the authentic reports of officers in the public service who have visited the mineral district and derived facts which they detail from personal observation. The explorations already made warrant the belief that the supply is very large and the gold is found at various places in an extensive district of the country. This set off the race to find the gold, and the 49ers started coming. This is a rocker box that they used for separating the gold out. Here's how it was used. There were two ways to get to California from the east. The quickest route was to take the East Coast boat to Veracruz and then up the coast on a boat. It takes about 5 months. Or you could take the land route, which took about 6 to 8 months, over the Oregon Trail or the Santa Fe Trail. This is a western finswift we found outside the museum. We'll now be driving a little bit. We'll go by the El Dorado County Jail and then look at James Marshall's house. This is the original. And then look at the James Marshall Monument. Then we'll be driving back through Coloma, California, which is the name of the town where the Marshall gold discovery was found. We'll be heading to San Francisco now. We'll have to drive back through Sacramento on the way to San Francisco. It takes us about 2.5 hours to get to San Francisco. Now let's look around the city some, since we have some time. Down the middle of the road we're driving on is the light rail in San Francisco, the SFMTA. One of the interesting things that we see in San Francisco is the houses are painted all different kinds of colors. No house has the same color, you see. As we drive along the highway into San Francisco, over the top of the cars, we can see the Golden Gate Bridge. This house is decorated for the Halloween that will be coming up soon. In San Francisco, you're either going up a hill or you're going down a hill. There's not much flat land here. Our first stop of the day is going to be Baker Beach. It's a beautiful beach on the Pacific Ocean, right outside the entrance to San Francisco Bay, and you can get some really magnificent views of the Golden Gate Bridge. It is located here facing the Pacific. We'll be talking more about the Golden Gate Bridge and its construction when we go over it in a few days. Right now, let's just look along the beach and see the waves crashing in from the Pacific.
And that's the open ocean out there.
Across the mouth of the bay is Point Reyes. We'll be over there in a few days and looking around also.
And here's the Golden Gate Bridge. Warm smell of
As we leave the park, we see many more of the beautiful homes that they have here. Not much yard, but the townhouses are really beautiful with their painted facades. And now we come to St. Ignatius Church, which we'll just see as we drive by. We'll be driving along the panhandle of the park here, and then we will be going to a famous area of San Francisco, Haight-Ashbury. This is where all the various hippies and other generations were here during the height of the hippie generation in the Love Inn in San Francisco. And we're going to drive around for a while. It's actually a corner. You can see many homeless people here, and you can also see the various stores they have here, some quite interesting. We will wind back and forth through the area for about 30 minutes looking at the various streets. There's a lot of one-way streets here. As we leave the Haight-Ashbury district, we go by the Painted Ladies. Now, these are Victorian homes that survived the earthquake and have now been painted beautiful colors, but we can't really see them too well, for the trees are in the way from the road. They're the ones on the right here. So let's look at it from a Google Map viewpoint, and you can see the houses. Now we move on to City Hall. We'll be driving by there. This is what it was like when it was being constructed, one of the first steel buildings, and this is what it's like now. And lastly, it's time to head to our hotel for the night, the castle. It's located where the arrow is, about three houses down from this corner. We'll be pulling in there and then going to register. They have two places you can park, one in the basement and the other underneath the building itself. You take the ramp up between the two buildings. We're going to be parking on the upper level at the handicap parking, which is right by the elevator. But to get in there, we have to twist and turn a whole lot. We'll be staying in this hotel for about 6 days, and this is our room. It's right by the elevator, so we just go to the elevator, go down and get in our car, and this brings us to the end of day 24.